right, we are getting a late start down to the upside down cockroach. I mean, when I heard the game was at 7:30, like most Clemson fans, I wasn't happy. Not because I'm scared of William Bryce at night in the stadium for players. Enough crazy junk happens down in Columbia during the day. Like most Clemson fans who hate going to Columbia, I'm there with you. Let's go Tigers and go down to the unholy land.
By nightfall, these hills will be swarming with orcs. We must reach the woods of Lothlorien.
Get it!
Clemson!
Here, I mean, this is one reason I wasn't happy about being here at nighttime, but...
Yo, look at all this beautiful scenery up in Columbia.
Yeah, they really. Is it recording?
Go Cocks!
Woo!
Only 6 years
to them. They're wearing Clemson.
You! You win! Okay. Kick ass!
Let's go Clemson!
You know what I mean? Yeah.
Here we go.
Sorry,
already
personal,
know what's
man.
Going on today.
Hey, Clemson.
Fun people show up so I can interview some. Alright.
Hello!
Tigers, yo. Yeah. Okay.
Go Gamecocks.
All kinds of fun comments.
Tigers.
Go Tigers. Road tile.
By 90 coming
up. Hey, what's that by 90 stuff coming from?
That's a bad.
Hey, is there a reason why by 90? Can we interview y'all?
Clemson is just better than Columbia.
Amen.
It's just better.
I love this pretty backdrop here of barbed wire and porta-johns. You know?
Hey, look above the barbed wire.
Okay, there.
That's what matters.
No, on second thoughts, let's not go to Camelot. It is a silly place.
All right, so I made it safely back out of Columbia, but Gamecock fans need to talk because I don't think y'all know how to use water bottles properly. All right, so Gamecock fans, I suggest you try drinking your water instead of throwing it. Then maybe you won't be quite as drunk. Of course, maybe South Carolina thought that they were doing some large stadium version of the Ice Bucket Challenge. All right, so believe me, I know Clemson's not perfect. We do have some Clemson folks do the middle finger tomahawk chop to the Florida State Seminoles when we play them, and we do have foul things that happen. Saturday was different. Even for me being in Columbia, it was different. We parked the truck, we walked around the corner, and literally you saw in the video, complete strangers cussing into the microphone without us even approaching them, putting the middle finger right in front of the lens. And so most of the Gamecock fans I've talked to have denounced those fans throwing bottles and the foul language and all that. But yet there is a group of Gamecock fans trying to bring this up to them and say, oh, stop being such a snowflake. Don't be offended by everything. Just get over it. It's not about being a snowflake or being offended. If you don't want to go to a game, get the middle finger, get told F you the entire time and have bottles thrown at you. That doesn't offend me, but in no way is that pleasant to be around. So I think we can ask ourselves as a fan base, what do we want to be about? I have noticed on social media boards is a lot of bandwagon fans who are now Clemson fans are hopping on there. And they sound like the trashy, vulgar, whatever fans that we don't like in other fan bases. I don't necessarily think this is a Clemson Gamecock thing. I think this is a human thing. Of when you see one human being cruel to another human being, what's your response to that? Are we really being PC or snowflakes by trying to be kind and polite? Or is that just good old Southern hospitality when we're kind and polite? And is that just common decency and those core values of being kind to one another and blessed are the peacemakers? Because, yes, it's fun to joke up with our rival, but there's obviously a line to cross. And to me, when it becomes just being baselessly cruel to another human, I ask ourselves, why choose to live in a world like that when we could live in a world that's better? So that's the question that I ask you. Likewise, we did run into many nice Gamecock fans, as we always do on this show, to show it is in good fun. We gave out friendship bracelets to the nice Gamecock fans we came across, and we even ran into some folks from Chester County, where I am from, and so it was actually not all bad down there. We do want to show this so we don't paint this ugly picture that it is all ugliness in Columbia. So here are the nice Gamecock fans we ran into. friendship bracelet to show that, you know, we do like playing our rival right. each year. So.
Straight up Gamecocks all day, baby.
I got you.
Hey, but I respect Clemson, man.
Yeah, respect y'all, too. There we go.
Okay.
There we go. Giving out friendship bracelets because as much as we don't like the rivalry.
Yeah, I appreciate
yes,
that,
sir. Rather. Thank you, sir. Thank you.
That. Honestly, I think this would be a great game. Great rivalry week. I love it. Go Cox.
I respect the rivalry.
We want to give you a friendship bracelet because as much as we don't like our rival, we'd rather play y'all than
no, not. Man. Respect that because you know, even if we are cross-state rivals, like I mean, I respect both teams.
Cox by 90.
That's it.
All right.
Say basketball.
Predictions on the game.
Definitely Cox by 90.
By 90. We've heard that a lot tonight. We've like five people come up to us and said that.
We're gonna win by 90.
Yeah,
at least above 80.
Okay, we didn't know that. Hey, Tom Hall, another Chester guy right here. Fairfield. So.
Yes, sir.
Tom Hall from South Carolina, Chester County, South Carolina. How you doing?
Tell us about your Mardi Gras thing you got coming up.
We raise money for various charities in Columbia, South Carolina with a Mardi Gras. And we do it in February, and it's really awesome.
Awesome. Thank you so much, Tom Hall. Plowboys.
Go Gamecocks.
Go Chester County.
Chester County,
right here, right now.
A Siddle Bulldog. Tell us about that victory here at William Bryce.
All I got to say is they felt pressured, but in the end, go Dogs, baby. Go Dogs.
So William Bryce does not intimidate Siddle Bulldog.
Oh, hell no.
Say, Clemson's God's country, right?
It is God's
country. They have the most beautiful campus ever.
Yeah.
I love going there. It's great to be a Tiger.